98online.com/livewire.
Recently, I've been having trouble with my sleep. And it's because of a very weird thing I find myself doing. Every night, I wake up in the middle of the night and I am strangling a homeless person. And I mean choking.
All
that's
right.
Not
Come
true.
On,
sorry.
Jesus!
Sorry, that's not true. Yeah. That's just a dream I had. God, I woke up ready to go. Every night at about 2 in the morning, I'm waking up to go to the bathroom as I usually do. I have a bladder the size of a chickpea, and my arm is mangled underneath of myself to where I'm trying to literally stuff my hand down the back of my mattress to keep it there, lay on the thing. And now I wake up and it's just knotted up underneath of me. Like, your arm will go to sleep. You'll get the sleepy leg, do the thing where you give yourself a stranger. You know what I'm talking about, a stranger. Take your arm and you know.
Yes.
But I'm waking up, and I mean, the amount of pain, there's been a couple of times I have to go and I literally get in my shower. I have to aim hot water on it.
What, you get in your shower in the middle of the night, put hot water on your arm to wake it back up?
Because, you know, you've ever watched TV and you just sit there for too long and all of a sudden, oh, my legs are asleep.
Your legs fall asleep, yeah.
But if I don't know how long I've been asleep. And for all I know, I've been there for hours choking off blood flow to my arm. It's been discolored when I've woken up. Not super discolored, but it's got a definite purple to it. And it's not just a whip it around type of thing.
How often does this happen?
Every
night?
And outside of sleeping in a damn
straitjacket.
Get
down on the floor and show me exactly how you wake up.
Let me show you this.
Take off your shirt.
Yeah. Get them pants off.
Here, I'll do it right here. All right.
Just lay down. Let me see. Now, if you were to be...
Okay, I go to sleep.
Yeah?
I go to sleep.
So you're laying on your back. You're on your back.
Or I'm one of these type of guys.
Back or side,
like
sleeper.
Okay.
And then where's your... What arm is it?
This arm here, my right arm.
Right arm.
I'm waking up like this.
And it's underneath you.
It's propping my chest up. My wrist is bent. My arm... My
so you're almost using it as like a little kickstand to keep
like
your body
I wake up.
Up
like this.
It's not underneath you. It's more to the side, but it's holding your body up on it. Maybe you need a side pillow. You need a side pillow, a sleep pillow.
Do I need a side pillow?
Yeah, one of them big, long, like side sleep pillows. Because it looks like you're using it as like a kickstand to keep your body up almost on its side. It looks like you're trying to be a side sleeper and you're keeping your body up.
And it
like
just,
this.
It's where the wrist bends and the elbow is like hyperextended. And I mean, I will wake up. And it feels like there are wasps in my muscles. Like, oh my God, I'm going to lose an arm like this.
Yeah, get gangrene.
I'm going to get gangrene, and then I'm going to die, and
it's
my cats
good.
Are going to eat
healthy.
My lips. Because you've heard stories about cats eating elderly people's lips after they've passed away, and not on my watch.
How many times has it happened?
It happens every effing night for months now. Now, here's the thing.
It's CrossFit.
I didn't start doing this.
CrossFit.
Is it CrossFit?
Yep.
Well, I'm done with CrossFit then. Can't wait to get fat
again. What else
again.
Could it be? What else has changed in your life?
My diet.
CrossFit, hence leading back to CrossFit.
Oh, God, is it CrossFit?
What else has changed
God
in your life?
Damn it, Alex! What else? I've recently switched over from X-Tube back to YouPorn.
No, I wouldn't do it.
And my diet, I've been eating a lot of kale and going to the bathroom a lot.
The question was, and
bad.
We talked about this in the meeting, was cutting off the blood flow. To that extent, like you said, you could be in that position for like, I don't think your body would let you go hours. I think it would be a matter of minutes until your brain woke you up.
You hear about people suffocating from, what is it, sleep apnea, where they'll close their windpipe off because they're big and fat, and they'll, and then there you go. This is like on the same shelf as that. Like my arm is gnarled
up.
Yeah,
but like I said, I think it would be a matter of minutes that your body would finally send the signal to the brain to wake you up because your arm has no blood. I don't think it's like hours that your arm is going without blood, but the question I pose is, could you be doing some sort of permanent damage?
Yeah.
Muscle damage, killing cells because it's not getting blood?
Well, do you feel
Does
anything
feel,
yeah, during
the
day?
Yeah. Does it feel weaker or worse?
It tingles until about the 7 o'clock hour. I wake up at 2, and for about 5 hours, you get the pins and needles, and it finally dissipates. And it's fine the rest of the day, and then rinse and repeat. I mean, I've thought about doing a sling. Like, I broke
my
arm
sling.
I'm
telling you, see the way you were on your side with your right arm down.
Right arm?
So elbow in. You lay facing that way.
Like this. Curled up like a little shrimpy fella. Like
a
prawn.
Get a side pillow. One of them big, long side pillows. Maybe hug it and prop yourself up on it. Might prevent you from... But this begs the question of weird sleep habits.
So...
Or weird... I Donald Duck. Everybody knows that.
Oh, by the way, that's probably been the best thing recently added to my sleep repertoire.
Are you Donald Duck now?
The Scott Reardon... Invitational Donald Ducking, where you sleep long t-shirt and not a stitch of clothing on from the waist down.
Put on a...
And you double that up with freshly powdered walnuts, and then you head to sleep like that.
It's almost like a nightgown. Like you put on like a
it's like a nightgown.
It's like a ghetto gown. Oh, it's probably a double X, triple X ghetto gown with nothing on the bottoms.
It's a 3X promotional Marlboro Miles menthol t-shirt.
Nice and soft.
Oh, so soft. All the graphic is just worn off of it.
And then your bottom. And your front are always nice and cool and aired out.
Well, if there's anything you know about me.
And if you ever need to do some business.
Definitely a bottom.
Some naughty business in the middle of the night.
Mm-hmm.
You're right there.
I'm just like, hey there. Well, you know, it's a little bit. Yeah, so I'm not sure if I want a pillow to sleep with. What if I...
We know Spiegs has night terrors and screams.
I do.
Screams in the middle of the night.
He definitely freaks out in the middle of the night.
And I snore.
Sweet dreams, Josh! Oh, God.
I got to keep my door locked because I frighten the dog and
your
children.
Family's coming over this weekend.
Buddy, you got kids coming over this weekend.
I just keep the door closed so they don't hear me.
All right, stick around after sports. We want to hear your weird-ass way that you sleep and make it sexy.
I got some texts. You don't even want to see them.
I don't even want to know. What? You know, give me... Screw it. Hit it.
One of them says, knew a dude who was an alcoholic... He passed out on his arm, and the arm needed to be amputated because he didn't wake up when he fell asleep because he was so drunk. He slept on his arm like all night, and the lack of blood flow, they had lopped that bad boy off.
That's what's going to happen. Get used. I'll tell you what, get in your push-up contests with me now because I'm not going to be able to do them come 2K15. Let's go to the phones.
This one person says her boyfriend was stationed in Germany for a few years, and he now talks German in his sleep.
I mean, that's cool. I mean, it's not something that's bad. Das time for the butt pinchers. Sleep dreams. All right. Let's go to line one. Jen joins us from Hunt Valley. Jen, what say you?
Morning.
Morning.
I have this weird thing where I will wake up, and I've actually got my hands around my throat, like, choking.
Whoa!
That is hot! Oh, what? Man. Really?
Oh, that is creepy.
Are you choking yourself, like, for real?
But are you squeezing or your hands just there?
Well, my hands are there. I'm not, like, squeezing, no. But my hands are, like, in that position of choking. And I wake up and I'm like, what the hell?
That is creepy.
If you don't mind me asking, and even if you do, I will regardless. Is that the sort of thing that you get down on when you're intimate?
Yeah, you into that or is that something you're into?
No, that is not quite what I'm into.
Okay,
no.
So then this is just completely out of
so you're just a goddamn maniac is all it is.
Wow.
All right, well, Jen, Godspeed.
Have you ever thought about getting talking to a doctor or something, or you don't care that much?
Nah.
All right.
It's never gone any further than just waking up. I mean, if I, you know.
That's weird.
Well, Jen, may I suggest that you fold it into your role playing because it is a damned fine time to watch someone's face turn blue in the throes of passion. Check in with us next week when we're at Beach Bass to see if you're still with us. Let's go to Kendall. Kendall joins us on line two. Justin Scott and Spiegel, what say you?
I'm on my way to the Annapolis graduation right now. My brother's graduating.
Yay. Oh, congratulations, my man. Congratulations, huh?
Thank you.
What the hell came of you? What the hell became of you, huh? He's graduating the Annapolis, the Naval Academy. What the hell went wrong with your batch?
I play baseball for college, but
okay.
I love what I do. Yeah. I'm training to be a cop right now, but
oh god, now I feel like a
dick. My weird sleep habit.
Yeah,
yeah.
I always wake up in my sister's bed. I don't know why.
Yeah, wait
I guess
a second.
I sleepwalk.
Yeah.
She in the bed?
Yeah, she's in the bed.
How old are you and how old is she?
Yeah,
great question.
I'm 19, turning 20, and she's 22.
Okay, oh great. I'm going to turn that music back up. God, had I found out that she's 7 years old and... She has to see someone.
It's his sister, though. 19 and 22, and you wake up in her bed?
Yeah, we're not that far from Waldorf, though. We turn a blind eye if the sun's gone down. Hey,
are you aroused?
I ain't mad at you, buddy. Oh, God, are you aroused? Are you aroused?
No, I'm not aroused.
All right, good.
All right, well, thank goodness.
I just wake up, and she's, like, in my face. I'm like, how'd I get here?
See, now, that is scary when you wake
up. Thank you, buddy.
Like a sleepwalk. He said he guess he sleepwalks. You go to sleep in your bed, and then you wake up somewhere else, and you don't remember.
Man. Thank God they're of
it's
age.
It's creepy.
Jesus, that would have been creepy.
It's still creepy, though.
It's still creepy, but
on a lot of levels.
It's diet creepy. It's Fisher Price, my first creepy. Let's go to Sean. Sean's on the program. Good morning.
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 I move my feet in my sleep. Sometimes I drive because I drive a truck. I'll have my arms all out in the air, and I'm driving in my sleep.
You're sleep driving?
Oh, you're hitting the gas and the brake in your sleep?
Yeah.
Whoa! Dude, I've had weird dreams. So that's like you're having a work dream. We have work dreams all the time. Hey, you're getting fired. Hey, you said this on the air. Hey, like, we're bringing back Kirk. Like, I have them constantly. So this is your middle-of-the-night work dream?
Yeah, he's like popping the clutch in his sleep.
I'll just have my arms out there, shifting, running to BTS.
Oh, and you steer, too? You steer and your feet? Oh, my God.
Yeah, the whole time. My wife tells me all about it. I mean, I don't know. I'm doing
we need video of it. Put him on hold.
Yeah, we're putting you on hold.
Your wife needs to film that.
Film that. If you film that and get it to us before the end of next week, I'm giving you Shindig tickets. We've got 100%. The audio. You're going to get tickets to the concert of the season. God, that's awesome. Oh, this one's a little dark. Wayne joins us in Edgewood, and I assume Wayne might do this even if he was awake. Wayne, morning.
I'm a very violent sleeper.
Mm-hmm.
I assume because I've had girls spend the night, and I woke up with a fistful of hair trying to pull their head off, punching them in my sleep. I punched a wall. When I wake up, my covers, my pillows every morning are on the floor.
Whoa.
I know. It's scary. I won't let anyone spend the night anymore.
So you're single, obviously.
Yeah.
Well, I'm kind of seeing someone, but I won't let her spend the night because she's a nice girl.
So what happens when you take the relationship to the next level? Separate beds or something? Or separate bedrooms?
I don't know. I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet, but I know I used to punch this girl, and she was a nice girl, too. And I woke up one morning, she was screaming, and I had the back of her hair... The back of her head, I grabbed a whole fistful of hair, and I'm pulling, and she was screaming.
Cool.
And you're sound asleep.
I'm sound asleep, but she woke me up once, and I said, "What's wrong?" And she goes, "You almost pulled my head off."
Oh my God!
What's the worst injury that these women have?
Yeah,
received?
Black eye, split lip.
Yeah, bloody nose. Anything?
No, I've never done that, but I've woke myself up punching her like in her back, like I'll punch her. And she'll go, ow, like that, and I'll go, what's wrong? And she'll say, you hit me.
Are you violent when you're awake? Do you ever get into fights?
Not at all.
Really?
When I was younger, I had a bad temper, but I'm not anymore. Now I don't get into fights. I'm 46 years old.
Yeah, but maybe you've buried that temper down. Maybe you need to go.
Coming back to the surface.
Yeah, at night, like Spiegel doesn't fart during the day, so he farts at night. Here's the other thing. He doesn't let out a lot of his pent-up tension and thoughts during the day, so he screams at night.
He yells quite a bit.
I don't give a damn.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm stealing from my death.
That comes out at night, so maybe you need to go like to a kickboxing class or do some MMA, like release some of that that energy during the day.
I do have a bad temper, but I control it now, you know?
Yeah, but you got to release the energy's still in your body. You got to get it out during the day. I'm telling you, try it, and I guarantee it'll work.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Wayne.
I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Can we
made that whole thing up, but it sounded good.
It sounded amazing.
It did. It was like an advice show.
I believe you.
Where'd that come from? I made that all up.
I choose to believe you. Wayne, you know exactly what you're doing. Let's cut the crap. You guys got into it in the middle of the day. She wanted to watch Say Yes to the Dress.
Right.
You wanted to watch Deadliest Catch. And you're just like, yeah, well, I guess I'm going to retire early just a little bit. Sleep well, baby. Sleep well. Quit deleting my SmackDown.
I hit you. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't mean to.
Oh, sorry.
I was asleep.
Sweet dreams.
The 98 Rock Morning Show with Justin, Scott, and Spiegel. 98Online.com.